Hi, this is Dr. A, and in this medical terminology video, we're going to go over the signs and symptoms of the respiratory system. Alright, so anosmia is the lack of the sense of smell. Anoxia is the inability to obtain oxygen from inhaled air. Aphonia is the inability to produce sound, and apnea is not breathing. Asphyxia is a lack of oxygen. It can lead to unconsciousness and death. And aspiration has two meanings. It can mean withdrawing fluid using suction. So like imagine a syringe with a needle and you're pulling fluid out of a joint. That would be aspiration. But in the context of the respiratory system, it can also mean inhaling food or liquid into the trachea. Bradypnea is breathing too slowly or a low respiratory rate. Bronchiectasis is dilated bronchi. Bronchospasm is an involuntary contraction of the smooth muscles in the bronchial walls. That can happen in asthma, for example. Shine-Stokes respiration is an abnormal breathing pattern with long periods of apnea followed by deep and rapid breathing. Clubbing is an abnormal widening and thickening of the fingers and toes due to chronic oxygen deficiency. This is often seen in COPD. Crackles are abnormal crackling sound during inspiration. It indicates fluid or mucus in the airway, also called rales, so it might be an indication of bronchitis or pneumonia. Cyanosis is blue skin caused by low oxygen in blood. Dysphonia is difficulty producing sound or producing abnormal sound. Dyspnea is difficult or labored breathing. Epistaxis is a nosebleed. Eupnea is a normal breathing pattern and respiratory rate. Hemoptysis is coughing up blood or blood-stained sputum. Hemothorax is the presence of blood in the chest cavity. Hypercapnia is excessive carbon dioxide in the body. Hypopnea is taking deep breaths, but hyperventilation is breathing too fast and too deep. Hypocapnia means insufficient levels of carbon dioxide in the blood. And yes, that is such a thing because there's a certain amount of carbon dioxide that is needed for proper acid-base balance. Hypopnea is taking shallow breaths. Hypoventilation is breathing too slow and too shallow. Hypoxemia is having insufficient oxygen in the bloodstream. And hypoxia is receiving an insufficient amount of oxygen from inhaled air. Laryngoplasia is a paralysis of the muscles controlling the larynx. Orthopnea is difficulty breathing, which is made worse by lying flat, so the patient breathes better sitting up, so they'll tend to sleep in a recliner or somewhere where they can be propped up. Pansinusitis is the inflammation of all the paranasal sinuses. Patent is open or unblocked, and that's what you want. You want a patent airway, an open and unblocked airway. Phlegm is the thick mucus that is secreted by the respiratory membranes. The pleural rub is a grating sound that's made when the layers of the pleura rub together during respiration. Pleurodynia is pleural pain. Pyothorax is the presence of pus in the chest cavity. It is indicative of a bacterial infection. Rhinitis is an inflammation of the nasal cavity. And rhinorrhagia is the rapid flow of blood from the nose, like a really bad nosebleed. And rhinorrhea is fluid discharge from the nose, so it's a runny nose. Bronchi are a musical sound that happens during expiration. It is caused by bronchial tube spasms, so you might hear that in a patient that has asthma. Shortness of breath, also abbreviated SOB, indicates that a patient is having difficulty breathing. It is also called dyspnea. Sputum is a phlegm coughed up from the respiratory tract. Stridor is a harsh, high-pitched breathing sound, and it indicates an obstruction in the airway. So maybe somebody is like inhale something into their windpipe and it's stuck. Tachypnea is breathing fast with a high respiratory rate. thoracalgia is chest pain, but it's not angina pectoris, so it is not chest pain from like a heart attack from the heart. It's chest pain from your thoracic cage hurting, or maybe from pneumonia. And tracheostenosis is the narrowing of the trachea. So that's the end of the list for your signs and symptoms of the respiratory tract.